Finally, let's talk about optimizations at the whole system level, including the interactions that happen between the host and the GPU. So on most systems, the CPU and the GPU are on different chips, and they communicate through something called a PCI Express bus, or PCIe for short. Today, for example, most systems are PCI Express Gen 2, which can, in practice, get about 6 gigabytes per second maximum in either direction. Now, PCI can transfer memory that has been page-locked, or pinned, and it keeps a special chunk of pinned host memory set aside for this purpose. So when you have a chunk of memory that you want to copy over to the device memory on the GPU, CUDA first has to copy it into the staging area before it can then transfer it over the PCI Express bus onto the GPU. This extra copy here increases the total time taken by the memory transfer. Instead, you can use the CUDA host malloc function to allocate pinned host memory in the first place, such that the memory you've got sitting on the host is already ready to copy directly over without this additional staging step. Or you can use the CUDA host register command to take some data you've already allocated and pin it, again avoiding the extra copy to take it into GPU memory. So that's why you care. Memory transfers from the host to device can go faster if you pin the memory first, and if you're transferring pinned memory, you can use the asynchronous memory transfer, CUDA memcopy async, which lets the CPU keep working while the memory transfer completes. How does that work? Well, with CUDA memcopy, which you've been using until now, you make a call to CUDA memcopy, you pass it some information like the pointers and the size and bytes and whether this is a transfer from device to host or host to device, and then there's a semicolon at the end of that statement. And with CUDA memcopy, the CPU blocks until the transfer completes. With CUDA memcopy async, when it hits the semicolon, it just keeps going. This kicks off an asynchronous memory transfer that continues to go on while control returns to the CPU and the CUDA program continues executing. In other words, the CPU can keep getting work done while this memory transfers. So to control that asynchronous interaction, we have to introduce the next topic in host-GPU interaction, and that's streams.